Get over here!
Get over here!
Welcome to the Friday episode of the Weekly Gobble, brought to you by three guys.
Na wala na sa banda nila.
Hindi na sila superhero.
Hindi na rin kami superhero.
We're just ordinary people.
In this ordinary world, looking for an extraordinary girl like...
Siya lang.
Ako din pala, teka.
Kami lang. Kami lang, ha?
Ako safe na.
Safe na to.
Shout out ka naman.
Hi, Nessa. Yeah!
Boys.
What's your name? Hi. My name is RD.
Hi.
I'm Joel.
Hi. I'm Luis.
And today, I'm Mr. X, and this is
the Weekly Gobble
Friday episode. So, this episode, we're going to tackle one of the pinnacle genres of being a geek.
Sci-fi.
We're going to talk about our top three
sci-fi movies.
Favorite live-action full-length sci-fi movies.
If you want to share your own top three, you can drop it.
Comment
section
below.
So let's share, let's discuss, and
let's have fun.
You first. Dude. Number three on your list.
Bakit?
Okay. Kasi yung dami. Top three, no? Star Wars.
What episode?
Return of the Jedi. Because, ano eh, meron akong experience. Yung drive ako. Tapos sa loob, papasok ng village. Tapos nun.
Tatawa ka na.
Kasi, hinara ako nung bagya.
Bakit?
Eh, hindi na akong sticker eh. Sabi ko, Nipasok na ako.
Hindi pa pwede.
Force yun, pare.
Force yun. Jedi mind tricks yun.
Jedi mind tricks.
Hindi lang yun, pare. My name is RD. Pag nilagyan mo yung 2, R2D2.
Alright!
I'm Aramat.
Number two.
Pastillas Rim.
Wait, what?
Pastillas Cream. Kasi, kasi yung isa, yun naman, maganda yun. Pero,
maganda!
Mas gusto ko si Guillermo eh.
Si Guillermo.
Kasi ano eh,
parang Guillermo kasi.
Yung appeal kasi niya, hindi siya yung toy line lang.
Tumabas
yung classic na big robots
fighting big monsters.
Hindi big robots lang.
Kaya nalagay ka na eh. Parang, di ba nga, may fan fiction na what if Godzilla is there?
Awesome. Kasi technically, Godzilla is kaiju.
Godzilla is a kaiju. Godzilla is the most famous kaiju movie of them all.
Yeah.
Think about it.
Di ba ano nga siya sa Japan? Ambassador na siya.
What?
Ambassador, citizen.
Basta one of those.
Basta may official title na siya.
Official title. Tapos diba, meron isang scene doon. If you haven't watched the movie, watch it na. Wala akong parang kung spoiler or what. Basta,
yung ginawa niyo... DVD!
Blu-ray. DVD. Binigyan na siya, diba? Tanker. Ship, diba? Ginawa niyo baseball bat.
That was so bad. Actually, isa pa sa mga shocking moments na nakita doon. Parang lumilipad yung kaiju.
Ayaw, yung biglang...
Grabe yun, like...
Tapos may niluwa pa kasi yung kaiju.
grabe yun.
Ang lumit doon.
Teaspoon si Kaiju.
John Tease.
John Tease.
Number one.
Number one.
Tron.
Which one?
Kung may lang ka.
Legacy or yung original?
I would say both eh. But then, doon tayo sa mas bago.
Glossy, it's Glossy V-Ray Love.
Dude, and that girl from CSI, si...
Clive Owen.
Yeah.
Clive
Owen. Yeah, si Olivia something.
Olivia Wilde.
Yeah. Ang hot niya, bro. Bro, she's
hot. Oh yeah, dude. Gusto niya na yung performance. She's so cute.
I know, right?
Actually, yung scene na habang nag-drive.
Diba? Parang gusto visual effects was on point.
Yeah.
Ganda. Magkakagawa. And it's a continuation of the original eh.
Yes!
So, I'm a sucker for those kasi yung may continuity.
Uh-huh.
Or parang passing on the mantle, parang ganun type.
You should watch Doctor Who right about now.
Yeah, I know. So,
anyway.
Ang ganda rin kasi nung original talaga eh. Parang breakthrough sa visual effects. Tapos on after naman lumabas ng Legacy, naglabas sila ng Tron Evolution.
Huh?
Kasi yung animated version.
Oh! Oh.
Ganda rin nun! Ganda rin nun! Yeah. It's awesome. Yeah,
it's awesome. It's awesome! You can be awesome. Glossy black.
Yeah, and I'm really hoping that they make another one.
So, binalik nila yung lights. They made light cycles fashionable.
Dude,
I want one. Mga gumagawa naman na lang eh.
Vroom, madama na.
Hey Jay!
Oh, I said matamaton. Yeah, so that's it for me. And what
about you?
Number 3!
1985, Terry Gilliam, Brazil.
Wala
nakakalam, okay.
Oh my god.
No. Sige, let's insert it.
I feel so inferior.
Okay, Brazil kasi para is one of the most underrated sci-fi movies that came out.
As evidenced by us.
Yeah. Diba? Parang ako na nakakalam. Oh my god.
Then, most likely viewers natin nakakalam din.
Okay, so. Pero parang ang plot niya is similar to 1984. It's a futuristic world na tapos yung mga machines nila. Sobrang wacky lang, pero futuristic siya kasi parang
yung future naman nila, hindi 2015.
Hindi naman. I forgot what year it was, pero ang wild lang ng production value niya. Tapos yung story niya is basically, hinahanap lang niya yung, basta may napapanaginipan siyang girl, tapos hinahabol niya, tapos basta it's very similar to what?
Okay lang yan, pala.
It's very similar.
It's
very similar to George Orwell's 1984. Pero yun,
not that.
Brazil, very underrated.
So number two.
Number two!
Ito, siguradong alam na na lahat.
Sige.
The Matrix.
Ano yun?
Ganyan kayo eh! Sabay pa kayo.
The Matrix,
Ang lupit nung ginawa nila ng 360 degrees na camera, ano ba na?
You got all
yung bullet time nila.
Bullet time, doon na usin yung bullet time. Pero more than the action sequences, more than the bullet time, syempre, it has a very interesting premise. And it makes you think talaga na, what if, kumbaga artificial lang tayo. Di ba?
Yung trippy part doon is na, yung... What if one day you realize that you are not in the real world, but you're in a computer-generated simulation of what you think is the real world? Red pill, blue pill.
What I love about it is the complexity of its themes.
Yeah.
Ang ganda ng the visuals. Ang ganda ng action sequences nila.
Action sequences.
It was flawless. It was ganda din.
And it's the Wachowski.
And number one!
1968, Stanley Kubrick. 2001, Space Odyssey. Di mo kailan si Stanley Kubrick? Oh my god!
Kailan ako Stanley.
Wrong Stanley.
The visuals were just flat out gorgeous.
Wait.
1968.
Pero
yeah,
it was a future.
Yeah.
Pero robot na pilot, di ba?
Dahal 9000.
Yeah, Dahal 9000.
Which means to be one of the most...
one of the creepiest AIs out in cinema.
Yeah. Yung theme din niya na sobrang lalim kasi it made you think na... Basically, it's about the evolution of man. The evolution of us as a species. From being apes na naka-discover ng first tool natin for self-defense to technology, and then later on it might want to explore saan kaya tayo papunta next, ano yung next phase natin of evolution. Di ba nakita mo naman yung Stargate sequence?
Oo, oh, pari, realize ang mga ganun.
Realize ang mga ganun.
Sila din yung ano, di ba? Sila din yung nagkasimula ng revolving corridors?
I'm not sure if sila nagkasimula, pero definitely, there was a shot na ganun.
They're all yung habang nasa...
Nag-jogging siya. Nag-jogging siya.
Nag-jogging siya. Nag-jogging
siya. It's for 1986.
1968. For 1968,
it was very revolutionary. Kasi alam ko, films like Inception and some other music videos. It took inspiration from that revolving platform.
Exactly. Ang galing lang. The normal moviegoers might not
appreciate it as much.
At first viewing siguro kasi yun niya, it has no clear plot. Uh-huh. So it relies mostly on visuals. Hindi nga ganun ka, ano yung dialogue.
It relies,
So you have to dig. Pero if you give it a chance, your patience will be rewarded because it's one of the greatest films I've ever seen. 2001.
Yeah. Watch that.
Space Odyssey.
Yay! Next!
Kumagana ang
stuff. And it's my turn!
Yeah, it's his turn.
Number 3!
Ano?
Interstellar.
Interesting.
Kasi ano, aside from yung scientific accuracy ng show and the stunning visuals, it got to a very interesting point about how time travel and gravity sort of work hand in hand. I'm really into the science-y stuff of things, kaya ako medyo madalas mangalikot ng gamit. Science is amazing. And the fact na you can signal someone through time by punching holes in a bookcase is amazing. Oh, sending a message. That part nung nandun siya sa loob siya ng Tesseract, tapos nakita niya yung, ano, yung booklets, tapos he was trying to signal, Merv.
Merv, don't let him leave!
You know, it kind of made you think, parang, posible kaya? I remember watching Interstellar and being reminded of the scary parts of being out of space. Out in space. Uh-huh. Yes. What's in a black hole? What happens to you?
Oh, because no one knows it. Oh. And another scary
aspect
or thing there is na ano, parang they were sorta alluding to they were the ones that sent themselves from the future. So
parang loop.
So parang ang nag-bring forward sa civilizations natin are essentially just like very, very, very futuristic human beings. So there's
that's a very interesting theory.
Time travel is a very, very tricky topic. Pero
it's a very complex thing.
It makes for a very amazing story device.
Yeah.
Time, speed, and gravity are somehow interlinked. An extent na hindi pa natin na-discover, and that's why I think
but it makes for an interesting theory.
Yes,
because it kind of makes sense kasi if it makes sense for you then it makes it more interesting, di ba?
And that's why I think that Interstellar is one of my top 3
science fiction
pieces of science fiction.
Number 2
something from the same guy that did District 9, Mr. Miho Kang. Yes,
I know that movie!
Chappie!
Second favorite sci-fi film kasi...
Of all time.
Alright. The visuals matter a lot to me. I sort of worked in visual effects before, so looking at that stuff, eye candy.
Plus, soon makita niyo yung mga work.
Soon. The story worked around a very organic AI unit. It has the capacity to learn, which is a very limited thing in current AI models. Kaya ako super amazed din sa movie na it is. They created an AI that can learn. And it created a lot of problems kasi its capacity to learn is not limited by hardware like we do. Chappie can learn forever. And he can string together ideas so fast that he could come up with new theories right around every day.
But Chappie is different,
because it's from an it's a very young robot, yeah, kasi basically. Yeah. Tapos, some people don't like that the AI are that smart.
And then, it might take them over.
Yes, right? And Wolverine got jealous kasi his beefier,
huge.
Yeah,
huge Jackman.
Huge Jackman.
Huge axe man. Yeah. It also dove into
nurturing.
Yeah, nature versus nurture. Yeah.
Chapin mo, Brad. Chapin mo.
I like it mostly because of yung themes and how it explained a lot and how it ends up to be. So, you should
watch it. Spoilers.
Check it out.
So we're at
number one. Gabi.
And number one is
Star Trek 2009 by J.J. Abrams.
So maraming lens flare yan.
Kaya ako siya gusto, kahit hindi siya yung super cult classic ngayon. It got two of my favorite people on board, J.J. Abrams. And yung composer is one of my favorite film scorers of all time.
Oh,
si
yes.
Michael Giacchino. Mm-hmm. Why I love Star Trek 2009 is, aside from its silly antics and Simon Pegg, basically dito sa film na to, they made it link with the old continuity of Star Trek. What they did was they made...
It wasn't a reboot.
It wasn't necessarily a reboot, but an alternate universe.
Okay.
Another thing that I like about Star Trek 2009 is the way that they directed the battle scene. Somehow that got me into starships.
Okay.
After that, anything related to any
starship
ships, it really sort of resonates.
Resonates.
Because there are games like Elite Dangerous and Star Citizen that I really, really, really want to get into. Because you get to pilot your own spaceship. It's not like EVE Online, it's point and click. Yeah, so that show really got me into spaceships a lot. And
you don't rewatch films.
Yeah, isa pa yun. May ugali kasi ako na.
Yun yung ano man eh.
Yun talaga. Pag napanood ko na yung film, hindi ko siya nire-rewatch. Parang, if I watch it again, parang, A rewatch of a film sort of takes out the joy of the first moment you see it.
Right.
Pero,
ito kasing sa Star Trek 2009, it's probably the only film na pinanood ko at least 5 times.
Wow, so you watch it again.
So, yes.
And again.
It's good.
And again.
So,
Oi, play!
Tapos yung ano. And that's why for me, Star Trek 2009 would probably be the best sci-fi live action film
of all time.
Current time.
And that's the Friday episode of the Weekly Gobble.
And my name is RD.
My name is John.
And I'm Mr. X. Goodbye. Live long and prosper. So, hey guys, if you liked that episode, please give us a like and subscribe to see more of our, yes. If you want to check out our last episode, click here. Also, we would really, really like your likes and subscribe. If you find it really entertaining, share it. It would mean a lot to us, so
share!
So, what are your favorite sci-fi films? Leave a comment below and maybe let's start a discussion because we need people to talk to. There's only three of us here and it's getting really, really boring.
And weird.
Help us. Don't bro me if you don't know me.